Since ancient times, the Maya have lived in a region that extends from southern Mexico through much of Central America. The heart of their civilization lay between the highlands of Guatemala and the plains of the Yucatan, much of it a vast region of dense jungle. Here, around AD 200, they began building their great cities, Tikal, Copan, and Palenque. They were renowned for their monumental architecture. Pyramids and temples towered over plazas and ball courts, where kings ascended to the throne and warrior athletes competed for their lives.
There were dramatic kinds of ceremonies and public events for public consumption, the exercise of power in its most dramatic forms.
Maya civilization thrived for over 2,000 years, distinguished by a sophisticated culture.
The art involves a level of graphic imagination and expertise that is unparalleled.
As Europe entered the Dark Ages, these city-states reached the height of their glory, some supporting hundreds of thousands of people.
They were the greatest of all New World civilizations and the only fully literate society in the New World.
Yet mysteriously, in the 9th century, the Maya abandoned many of their cities. The temples and pyramids in the central lowlands were swallowed by the forest and forgotten. Almost 1,000 years later, a Spanish explorer named Jose Calderon stumbled upon the jungle city of Palenque. Inside its abandoned temples, Calderon and his men found huge stone tablets carved with figures and hieroglyphic writing.
It's really clear that they're looking at something that's totally alien to them. And they're wrestling with this idea whether it's picture writing or whether it's something more than that.
As news of the strange text spread, French artist Jean-Frédéric Waldeck traveled to Palenque in 1832 to sketch its hieroglyphs. Believing that Babylonians, Phoenicians, or Hindus had built the Maya cities, Waldeck's drawings even included Indian elephants.
We now know that the Maya weren't even writing anything that visually looked like an elephant. He was not understanding the forms of the signs. And this is the theme that you see time and time again with artists trying to record Maya inscriptions up until the 20th century.
As more sites were discovered, explorers did their best to draw the unfamiliar glyphs. But their work lacked the detail needed for decipherment. Everything would change in the 1880s when Alfred Maudsley arrived with a glass plate camera.
Maudsley was taking full advantage of the new developments in photography. He had gone into all of the sites fully equipped with large format glass plate negatives and immense effort, these caravans of equipment.
You see these lovely photographs with the entire Great Plaza cleared. Well, it wasn't that way when he got there. He had to set a lot of people to work.
December 21st, 2012, the Earth will be in exact alignment with the Sun and the center of the Milky Way galaxy, a galactic event that takes place only once every 25,800 years. No one knows what effect this extraordinary alignment will have on the Earth, but the Mayans believed it would be dire.
It might be kind of like a crossing over of the kind of galactic equator. When you go below, you know, south and north, magnetic currents will spin in opposite directions. It might be there's a kind of field effect reversal that takes place once you pass through this galactic equator.
Geophysicists have a theory that is strikingly similar to the events predicted by the Mayan alignment.
You know, south and north, magnetic currents will spin in opposite directions. It might be there's a kind of field effect reversal that takes place.